Bush.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will faithfully execute.
That I will faithfully execute.
The office of President of the United States.
The office of President of the United States.
And will to the best of my ability.
And will to the best of my ability.
Preserve, protect, and defend.
Preserve, protect, and defend.
Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
You can't believe how many times I've talked, but it still comes down. My son was murdered, and I haven't gotten the answers that I want. And I'm bitter, and I'm angry. So that's why it makes it very difficult. It's tough, like. You know, I talk to so many people, and so many people are rational, and they really have great answers. And this is a fault of mine. And one of the positive things is I bring passion to this. But one of the faults is I want my answers now, immediately, and I want the perpetrators of the murder of my son. And I've spent 6 years going to every commission hearing, talking to so many people. And there's simple, simple questions, just simple questions that the media won't talk about. My God, if I can't have a rational conversation with my neighbor about Tower 7 coming down, they look at me and say, what are you, nuts? These are my neighbors. It's tough to get 5-minute conversation with them. That's insane. Absolutely insane. And this list goes on and on and on and on. And I've gone my entire life believing that what our government does is right. And I've always believed that. And she's, you know, 57, 58 years old now. And she says, that's the first time I've looked at our government and said, geez, maybe everything isn't true.
August 2nd, 1990, Saddam Hussein's forces crashed through the defenses of oil-rich Kuwait. In fear of an Iraqi invasion into Saudi Arabia, the United States and her coalition allies poured into the Arabian Peninsula to form a deterrent that would be known as Desert Shield. The result was a series of diplomatic talks, negotiations, and counter-negotiations that rapidly declined into a no-hope situation.
Clearly, I've never been there, but it feels like we're in the center of hell. There continue to be these flashes of light often.
The conflict was witnessed by millions through the eye of CNN and the BBC, showing propaganda of the systematic eradication of Saddam's forces by a coalition far superior in technological, political, and economic power. However, what was little known was that from the outset the war was engineered, controlled, and manipulated by an elite group. A group which had created the illusion of a man with power, at the head of a million-strong army, on the verge of going nuclear. A man who had gained control over one-fifth of the world's oil overnight. However, in reality, he was merely a pawn, in amongst many pawns. Just a puppet in a grand master plan, with the Gulf War as a well-orchestrated stepping stone.
What is at stake is more than one small country. It is a big idea, a new world order.
America will not impose our own style of government on the unwilling. Our goal instead is to help others find their own voice.
He should have been killed a long time.
By whom?
By anyone.
Se destituyen de sus cargos ilegítimamente ocupados al presidente y demás magistrados del Tribunal Supremo de Justicia.
Dictadura, queremos a Chávez. Chávez,
presidente de Venezuela. Pensé que iba a morir.